This call, please stay connected. Good and welcome to Deepak Nitrite Limited Q4 and full year FY20 earnings conference call. As a reminder, all participant lines will be in the listen-only mode, and there will be an opportunity for you to ask questions after the presentation concludes. Should you need assistance during the conference call, please signal an operator by pressing star then zero on your touchtone phone. Please note that this conference is being recorded. I now hand the conference over to Mr. Nitin Tiwari from Antique Stock Broking. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Thanks, Neil. Good afternoon. On behalf of Antique Stock Broking, I welcome everyone to Deepak Nitrite Limited's fourth quarter earnings call. We have with us the senior management team represented by Mr. Asekar, CEO, Mr. Upadhya, CFO, and Mr. Nanda, Senior GM, Finance. I would now hand over the call to management for their opening comments, which shall later be followed by a Q&A session. Over to you, sir.
I'm Umesh Asekar here. Good day, everyone, and a warm welcome to you on Deepak Nitrite's Q4 and FY20 earnings conference call. I hope everybody is safe at home during this pandemic situation. Do take very good care of your family and yourself. Wishing you all good health and strength during these very difficult times. I'm sure all of you have glanced through the results documents which were shared earlier and also uploaded on stock exchanges and our website. I'm pleased to inform you that despite the disruptions caused by the spread of the COVID-19 pandemic, we have ended FY20 on a solid note with strong top-line growth and have reported highest PAT ever. Our revenues for the quarter stood at 526 crores, up by 8% when compared to rupees 488 crores in Q4 of FY19. We have witnessed volume growth, improved realization, while also being able to drive efficiencies in the operations. As a result, EBITDA for the quarter stood at rupees 185 crores when compared to rupees 111 crores in Q4 of last year, FY19, registering a growth of 67%. This quarter witnessed a substantial reduction in finance costs, and we also benefited from a more favorable rate of tax, which has helped to elevate the profitability. PAT for the quarter stood at 116 crores, higher by a resounding 106% when one compares with rupees 57 crores in the Q4 of the earlier year, FY19. Deepak Nitrite has continued to benefit from the favorable developments taking place in the global chemical industry. With China de-emphasizing its chemical manufacturing and global market players looking to establish supply arrangements in alternate markets, including India, we as a company will leverage our vast industry expertise to capture the market share. With the global spread of the novel coronavirus, we believe there may be some acceleration in the shift to diversify and de-risk supply chains. We believe we are well-placed and globally competitive with established operations and high degree of forward and backward integrations. The steadfast focus on ESG protocols makes us a preferred supplier for major global customers. To give you an update on the performance of Deepak Phenolics, DPL, that is, completed its maiden full year of operations with production volumes close to 200,000 metric tons per annum. That is 100% of capacity utilization. This slight shortfall is attributed to the 10-day shutdown in March 2020 due to the nationwide lockdown. To almost reach 100% capacity in its maiden year of operation validates the scale of effort and preparedness backed by the efficient management of complex material logistics. Performance has progressively improved in each quarter of the financial year 2020. Had the shutdown not been imposed, the volumes and revenues in Q4 would have exceeded the watermark we achieved in quarter three of FY20. Moving on to the operational performance. In Q4 of FY20, our domestic revenues stood at 264 crores as against 345 crores in the corresponding period last year. The revenue growth was due to the national lockdown which was imposed by the government of India. During the quarter, we decided to take advantage of favorable pricing conditions in the global market, and to enable this, we focused more on volumes to exports. Revenues from exports stood at 257 crores in Q4 of FY20 as against 138 crores in Q4 of FY19, delivering a robust growth of 86% year-on-year. This growth was mainly driven by solid demand for our finance specialties and our performance product segments in the exports market. Looking at the segment-wise performance in Q4 FY20, the basic chemicals revenue moderated due to closure of production facilities due to the national lockdown. Revenue growth in the finance specialty segment came in at 30% in Q4 of FY20 owing to strong demand and favorable realizations in our export markets. The performance product segment reported a growth of 22%. The performance product performance was driven by DNL's initiative to reorient the mix of geographies and end-user industries. This resulted in better product acceptance and higher realizations. Leveraging from its backward integrated operations, the company also capitalized on favorable demand supply situation for Dalda caused by disruptions in China. Another key development was that DPL, Deepak Phenolics, started commercial production of isopropyl alcohol, IPA, at its manufacturing facility at Dahej, Gujarat, effective April 21st, 2020. This facility has capacity to manufacture 30,000 metric tons of IPA annually. This is in line with our efforts of getting into value-added derivatives of phenol and acetone through forward integrations. This is the first step towards achieving that vision. We started resuming production at our plants from mid-April and current capacity utilization across various plants is around 70%. We are observing all requisite precautions for the health and safety of our employees. The logistics and labor availability did face some disruptions. However, this is getting increasingly normalized as we speak. Order inflow from various customers, both domestic and global, remain unaffected. While there were deferments which are unavoidable, the company has not witnessed any significant order cancellation due to COVID-19 pandemic. As a best practice, we have also reached out to all our customers with the status of their shipments and tentative delivery timelines throughout this period. Before I conclude, let me share a key development, personal key development. After completing 12 years with Deepak Nitrite, I will be retiring on 31st May 2020 and as approved by the Board of Directors, Sri Maulik Mehta will be elevated to the position of Executive Director and CEO with effect from 1st of June 2020. I congratulate Mr. Maulik Mehta and wish him luck in driving continued success for our stakeholders. I am more than happy to be replaced by Maulik and I am very confident that he shall drive the company with more enthusiasm, more passion and more vision under Deepak's guidance and take our company to far, far greater heights. I am sure about this in about our Deepak Nitrite. Let me conclude by saying that we remain confident on the agility and nimble-footedness of our business operations and are well positioned to rebound quickly as the operating environment stabilizes. Thank you. I would now hand over to the call to our Director of Finance and CFO, Mr. Sanjay Upadhyay, for his comments. And after that, our new CEO and Executive Director, Mr. Maulik Mehta, shall also speak to you. Please welcome Mr. Maulik Mehta to his new responsibilities and wish him all the best. God bless. Over to you, Mr. Sanjay Upadhyay, for a while.
Thank you, Mr. Asaikar. We had a wonderful and glorious area with you. While we shall miss you, Mr. Maulik Mehta, being an able leader, will take the company to new scales. I welcome Mr. Maulik Mehta, who takes charge as CEO and ED with effect from 1st June 2020. We wish all the best and happiness to Mr. Asaikar. I request Mr. Maulik Mehta to address this forum briefly before I take you through the financials.
Good afternoon, everybody. Thank you all for joining this call. I'm delighted and fortunate to have this great honor. And it also brings a lot of opportunities and challenges, especially in this current global situation, to take the company forward. I assure you all to be working for the company to take it to aforementioned heights and values. Assuming the responsibility that Mr. Asaikar is handing over to me, I am appreciative that I have high shoulders and large shoes to fill. I convey my sincere thanks and gratitude to Mr. Asaikar for taking this company to storied heights, and I shall put all effort to take our company further, keeping our triple P of people, planet and profit in mind. I hand over now to Mr. Upadhyay.
Thank you, Maulik. Good afternoon, everyone, once again, and welcome to Deepak Nitrite's Q4 FY20 earnings call. Before I will take you through the financial highlights for the quarter in March 2020, let me first all thank Mr. Asaikar for his guidance, support and contribution to the growth of Deepak Nitrite during his tenure. His contribution to the company has been exceptional and is difficult to summarize in words. I personally enjoyed working with him. On behalf of Deepak Nitrite family, I wish him continued good health and very best for the future. As you all are aware, this quarter bears an impact of lockdown from 22nd March and hence due loss of production dispatches. We lost turnover of around 50 crores and margin of around 30 crores. Hence, this quarter's numbers are to be seen in light of this. A quick word on operating environment, which is changing every few days. The lockdown imposed on our plants are disrupted year-end shipments and result in a higher inventory as of closing date. In the initial days, even the banking channels and our customers were getting accustomed to the situation, which led to slightly higher receivables position than anticipated at the end of the year. In recent weeks, our operations as well as those of customers having recommenced liquidity in the market has improved considerably. This has helped to move forward with some liquidation of inventory as well as restart of collections from customers, enabling an improved working capital situation at the current date. Let me assure investors that our liquidity position remains comfortable. We have not opted for moratorium given by the RBI and we have been serving our debt on schedule even during the lockdown. And we have still surplus unutilized working capital funds available with our banks. We are monitoring the situation on a real-time basis and will inform all stakeholders accordingly. As you all have seen, our overall borrowing position has been reduced significantly during the year. Now moving to the financial highlights, all the figures are standalone. Total revenue for the quarter stood at 526 crores as compared to 488 crores in Q4 FY19. EBITDA came in at 185 crores as against 111 crores in the corresponding period last year, delivering a strong growth of 67%. EBITDA margin came at 35%. PBT stood at 160 crores in Q4 FY20, higher by 84% when compared to 87 crores in the same period last year. Profit after tax for the quarter stood at 116 crores as against 57 crores in Q4 FY19, delivering a robust growth of 106% year-on-year. Depreciation for the quarter was 21 crores, while the finance cost declined by 54% to rupees 5 crores in Q4 FY20. Coming to our segmental performance in Q4 FY20, revenue from basic chemicals stood at 226 crores against 250 crores in Q4 19. This segment contributed around 42% to total revenue. EBIT increased by 30% to 56 crores with EBIT margin of 24.8%. In the fine and specialty chemical segment, the revenues came at 158 crores in Q4 FY20, growing by 30% year-on-year. Fine and specialty segment contributed 29% of the total revenue with an EBIT of 50 crores and EBIT margin at 32%. Revenues from performance product segment stood at 154 crores in the quarter with strong growth at 22%. This segment contributed 29% of the total revenues with robust EBIT of 75 crores with a margin of 49% versus 38% in the same period last year. For the quarter under review, consolidated turnover stood at 1058 crores, PBT came stood at 201 crore and PAT at 172 crores respectively. Moving to our balance sheet position, our total standalone debt stood at 208 crores at the end of the quarter. The debt to equity ratio on a standalone basis was at 0.14, indicating the strength of our strong financial position. On a consolidated basis, debt to equity ratio stood at 0.69, which is very comfortable. With that, I would request the moderator to open the forum for question and answer session. Thank you.
Thank you very much. We will now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question, you may press star and one on your touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. Anyone who wishes to ask a question, you may press star and one. Thank you. first question is from the line of Samir Balod from AM Fund Advisors. Please go ahead.
Yes, hi. Congratulations on a great set of numbers. My first question is if you could just provide, we've heard some press articles which mentioned that the DASDA prices, which were ruling at about $17, have crashed down to $4, which contributed to a lot of your 49% EBIT margin in the performance product segment. So if you can comment on that, on how the DASDA and the performance product business is likely to perform in the next few quarters, given what has happened to DASDA prices.
DASDA, if you remember, we had always been saying that this level is not sustainable, whatever was the level last year. And now, unfortunately, on top of it, we have this corona impact. So the demand for DASDA and the end user industry like OBA, particularly the paper and this, is going down. So DASDA will have that impact now. DASDA prices have gone down. Earlier, we were saying that it will be a new normal, which was according to a $7 to $8, but it has gone down, and we feel it will remain at between four to five now. But situation is evolving and emerging. Today, nobody can say with confidence what is going to happen. But it's not that we are losing or the margins are good enough, but not like earlier. Of course not.
So, any sort of guidance you can provide on what sort of margin that you can maintain even with these low prices for the next few quarters?
It is like if you go 1 year back, the same prices were there in the market.
Okay. So, the second question is if you can talk a little bit about phenolics, on what you are seeing with respect to demand for phenol, what sort of spreads that or cracks you are currently enjoying, and anything on the demand, given that some of the end user industries may be suffering because of the impact of COVID. So anything on phenolics that you can provide as guidance for the next few quarters?
Guidance in the sense, yes. Phenol demand is slightly down, but acetone is doing well. IPA we have started. In fact, we are very proud to say again that during the lockdown, when nothing, our team worked very hard. We had a contract labor team sitting in our factory. We provided them all accommodations, and we saw to it that we start and commission our plant. If you must have seen, we commissioned our plant on 21st of April during the lockdown. So that business is certainly doing well. So phenol is slightly low, but that doesn't mean that phenol is not doing well. Phenol is of course doing well, and with acetone and IPA prices going on, phenol business is also reasonably doing well. I won't say it's there is nothing to worry about.
Sir, in the IPA, you had mentioned somewhere that it's a 30,000 tons per capacity. What would be the total turnover at full utilization for IPA?
Around 300 crores.
300 crores, is it?
Yeah. But of course, prices will vary. So,
okay. And sir, if I can squeeze in the last question, any sort of capex plans with respect to downstream products for phenol as well as further uses of acetone downstream? Anything that has been formalized or finalized?
Of course, we had planned, but now because of the lockdown and shutdown and this corona, we are reworking on everything. So there is a delay in capexes. I think this is not the right time to talk about major capacities. I will come back in the next quarter on this with more clarity.
Okay, sir. Thank you. I have a few questions. I'll get into you. Thanks.
Yeah, thanks, Samir.
Thank you. Next question is from the line of Roshan Naik from Aquintas Wealth Advisors. Please go ahead.
Thanks for the opportunity. So in DASDA, DNL benefited because of environmental crackdown on largest producer in China. So is that player back, or can you provide some idea on that?
There is more than that, is a demand compression.
Okay.
So once the demand is normalized, we'll see how DASDA emerges again.
So there is no much clarity on that player is back or not.
There is no new capacity has come. That player is there. Even China is also again working on their plans and this. So let's see how it goes. You know, today what we are seeing is Dasda, of course, demand is down and the prices are also low. So I think next quarter will give more clarity on that.
Okay. So and my next question is, like, apart from IPA, what are the other plans in forward integration for downstream derivatives? Can you throw some light on that?
There are plans, as I mentioned in the earlier question also, there are plans, but I think we will wait for more clarity because, see, things have gone, I mean, last couple of months are really, really putting everything on a, I mean, we have to think about our plans and this and just reassess where do we stand. So maybe next quarter will be a better time opportunity to share with you in detail.
Okay. I shall come in at this moment. Last, since 24th of March, our efforts, our focus has been completely on very safe shutdowns of our plants. Shutting down chemical plants is not a casual matter, it's not a joke. Taking good care of our people, making them slowly, slowly join our manufacturing facilities, observing all norms of social distancing and one by one stepping up our capacity utilization of every plant. As said earlier, we are at 70% capacity utilization. Some plants operate at 100%, some plants may be operating at 50%. So our whole energies have been sapped by keeping our plants and our people safe. And now they are back, keeping them safe while producing. So this is the whole energy has been sapped. So when you ask all these questions, really, we don't know how to answer these questions. If the second wave comes, I'm told it is coming back in Wuhan, in China. We really don't know. So let's keep questions about our future to the next quarter meeting. We'll have lots of clarity.
Sure.
I hope you understand.
Sure. So due to lockdown, did you see any challenges in procurement of raw materials? How is the situation now?
In fact, if you see lockdown also, we ran our plants. We started, because it falls under essential commodities. So as Mr. Asaikar mentioned, we started our plant in a safe environment and in a phased manner. Overall capacity utilization would be around 70%, but some plants are at 100%, some started late, so around 60-65%. But no problem on material, no problem on labor, and even logistics and this was a big challenge, but that also we could overcome. So by and large, things are, I won't say extremely, absolutely hunky-dory, but things are reasonably, reasonably good for us.
Okay. How
about... Sorry to interrupt you. May I request to come back in the questions for a follow-up question? Thank you. A request to all the participants, please restrict to 2 questions per participant. If time permits, please come back in the question queue for a follow-up question. The next question is from the line of Paras Votra from Ashika Stock Broking. Please go ahead.
Thank you for the opportunity. This is with regard to the IPA. The government has come with a ruling where it has restricted the prices of IPA at 69. Can you please throw some light on the fact that this 69, when it is capped at, what is the market price ruling and what is it that you are going to sell for sanitizers and for other sectors like pharma or whatever sectors requires the IPA?
There is a cap on the price when supplies for the sanitizer industry. So some portion of IPA goes to that and some portion of IPA finds application in pharma and other. So pharma prices are different and the government controlled sanitizer prices are different. So it's an average what we are saying.
Average could be looking at the capacity at 30,000. So when you say 300 crores, so average could be 100 rupees per kg is what we can assume.
That's what I say. Now this can be, it can be 330 also, it can be 270 also. I mean, nobody can say today what price is, tomorrow it will be. But this is the on an average, we are saying 300 crores turnover.
Okay. And what is the total market-wide capacity, if you can say?
Can I complete?
Yeah, sorry.
Because
please.
Tomorrow the prices can go down and then 100 can become IP 70 also. Because IPA, how far this remains, or it can go to 120, 130. So, don't just go by the The current estimate of ours is 300 crores. Okay.
And what is the industry capacity here in India? And if you can say any new capacity is coming up in the IT?
The Indian capacity is 1 lakh, 70,000 I think, total 1 lakh. So we are at 30,000.
Okay. And what is the current price? This is the last question of ITA in the market.
I said no. I cannot be giving you exact price at which we have different customers and we are saying the different markets.
But beyond a point, one would not like to disclose information because we are in a very competitive world and this is our intellectual property also, which we would not like to disclose. But what is more important is all of you should be very proud of Deepak Nitrite. That we consider it as a part of our national duty that we got in challenging circumstances the IPA plant into commercial operations, and the commercial operations started at a nice level from 21st of April, and your company gives priority to all sanitizer consumers, not because government has mandated. Government has put a cap on price. It's not about that. It's about doing the national duty by supplying IPA to sanitizers. So I think let's go beyond financial numbers and talk about things like these things. You know, these are emotions. These are challenging times. No colleague of mine, when the word greedy doesn't touch us here in Deepak Nitrite. We do our national duty first. And we're very proud of it. I am very, very proud of it.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Next question is from the line of Tejas Sen from Nippon India Mutual Fund.
Good afternoon, sir. Mr. Asaikar, it's always been good interacting with you, so all the best for your future endeavors. I have one question. In the opening remarks, you did mention that that the demand scenario is not very, very bad. If you can just elaborate on that how the global demand environment is, because we have a substantial share of exports, and any particular sector which you are seeing some pressure on the demand side at the application level.
Okay, me being a continual student of business strategy, I love to talk from that point of view, and you should have these kind of perspectives when you take any investment call on any company. Most important, Deepak Nitrite has spread its eggs in many baskets. And we have so many application industries as our customer. We just started pharmaceutical industry and sanitizer industry as our customers. So our eggs are spread in all baskets. And therefore, we have some shock. Something goes wrong in one segment, but then that is more compensated and sometimes more than compensated in another segment. So that is the reason that we are saying that more or less we are confident that our customers are doing fine and there is a good demand for our products. This is point number two. Point number three, except this MSME sector, we don't see any demand compression to that extent. And we have business partnerships with various agrochemical industries and all that, so we don't see many challenges. Your company has tied up its logistics in challenging times very, very well. When it comes to finding out novel, innovative solutions for getting the raw materials to our doors, to reach our materials under challenging circumstances, to the ports, finding right ships, changing ports at the last minute, all that we have done. And this working from home was a great experience for all of us, because we knew only 3 days in the company. Even today we know only 3 days, that is yesterday, today and tomorrow. And working from home gives you opportunity to work for practically 16-17 hours a day while enjoying your homely atmosphere. So I think I answered your question. The risk has been reasonably distributed over various business segments. Only MSME segment in India is a bit of challenge. We are extremely careful about our debt management. No debt of ours has turned even doubtful as on debt. Nothing doubtful, nothing bad, no issues. We are trading very, very carefully.
Yeah, thanks. Just to follow up on that, on the export side, this whole shift of China to India, are there any more inquiries which you have seen in last 2 months on your diversified portfolio side?
Of course, we do get inquiries and we are working on it. I mean, there is nothing. I mean, business is, see, let me tell you, on all the fronts, as Mr. Asikar was mentioning, everywhere in all the segments, we are doing reasonably well. We keep getting inquiries. We have not seen too much, I mean, the worry that demand is going down or business is not doing well. Yes, certain segments, as you rightly asked, for example, I'll give you, say, ply industry is currently, because of shutdown and lockdown, not doing well. Or the paper industry not doing well. But the other industries like detergent is doing really well. You know, so these things keep on happening. And I mean, we are not worried on this. So by and large, things are under control. There is something which is beyond our control. We are trying to mitigate those risks. We have managed well up till now. Whatever we have done at plant, whatever we have done with the customers on raw material front, on labor front, I mean, things are under control. So by and large, we don't see any big disruptions at our end.
And I was talking more from opportunity point of view. Are there any more inquiries coming from global customers on a larger sourcing for this year?
We are getting inquiries. We are getting inquiries. But, I mean, it will take some time, Tejas.
Okay. Nothing which is very alarming on the demand, on the increased demand side.
Not in a very big way.
Okay. Just last question. Is there any larger cost measures which you are looking this year to control basically the cash outflow?
Nothing. I mean, we do not. As a company, we are always cost conscious. We do not, I mean, you people know us well, we do not spend unnecessarily or nothing like that. So, nothing significant as such.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Okay, Anand, this type of questions will keep coming. That's why I need to tell something more. There is going to be GDP compressions across the globe, right?
Yeah.
But now, for a chemical industry, Indian chemical industry, so generally speaking, this demand compression and GDP degrowth get compensated by the kind of suspicion and mistrust that people are carrying in their hearts about China. Therefore, if X plus Y is equal to 100 is coming down to 80 or 90, that Chinese portion will take the more hit and the things will come to Indian chemical industry. So Indian chemical industry is not going to face post-COVID, a major issue of capacity utilization and all that. Because actually trust factor is going on very badly about China.
Yeah, exactly. Other chemical companies are talking about this.
GDP growth will come down, America will degrow and everybody will degrow. India also will degrow. But this demand compression which has happened, that hit will be more on China than on rest of the nations, and including India.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Next question is from the line of Madhav Marda from Fidelity Investments. Please go ahead.
Hi sir, good afternoon. So I just want to know the largest industry, end user industry for Deepak Nitrite is colors. Am I right?
Is
colors in pigment, is that the largest industry for it?
It's agro, not colors.
Okay, could you give us the end industry mix for Deepak Nitrite as a whole for our portfolio? Which are the industries we supply to?
We supply to agro, we supply to paper, textile, detergent, so many segments we supply, pharma, glass,
explosives,
pesticides.
Heat transfer chemicals, water treatment chemicals,
and dyes.
Okay, got it. So the impact we are facing is mainly on the paper and the textile side, and agro and pharma is doing well, right? I think that's the right interpretation.
Yes, you are right. Even dyes is not doing that bad.
Okay.
More or less, as I mentioned, our industries are, end user industries are doing well, except barring few. Not a major concern as such.
Okay. And just one last question from my side. The like you rightly said, market share gain for us will compensate for any GDP compression. But in terms of prices for our products, can they hold up at current levels, or could we see some pressure in the coming year?
Of course. In fact, we have not seen any price erosion in the first few 2 months, and neither we are seeing in future also, as on today. Except again, Dazda, what we discussed a few minutes back.
Okay. Great, sir. Thank you so much.
Dazda, and of course, OBA goes with that.
All right.
Thank you. Next question is from the line of Rohan Gupta from Edelweiss Financial Service. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Sir, this phenol demand is likely to come down significantly because of this plywood industry under trouble. Our acetone production is a byproduct on the phenol. So do you see that though there is a significant demand of acetone, which is not affected much, but with a fall in phenol demand, it will be difficult for us to operate our plant?
See, phenol demand down doesn't mean that we are not running our plant at good capacity. Of course, we are running our plant at good capacity. So we, it's not that the phenol demand is down because of these temporary lockdowns and shutdowns. But in spite of that, we are as a company, Deepak Phenol, we are doing well. Acetone is doing well, IPL is doing well. Phenol is of course down, but then not that it is going down to the below 50% or 40%. Aisa kuch nahi hai.
My whole point that phenol and acetone both are co-product.
Yeah, so to that extent, if phenol production is low, then acetone will certainly, the availability will be low. That is, of course, which will happen. But we are not seeing that much reduction in the production.
At what level, sir, our phenol acetone plant is operating right now? Utilization?
See, we started a phenol now, it's very difficult to say. We started our plant late in April. So today we are running at around 65-70%.
Okay, that's what I was asking. So today it's running at 60-65%.
I said 65-70, not 60-65. So it is up from between around 70, you can say.
Okay, so it's running at 70%. And with the current scenario, do you see that in a month of June, we will be able to go up to 85% something?
Of course, see, why? Aap lockdown uthao na, bhaiya.
In my hand, definitely, I'm not able to. Not that situation, or if anybody is.
Are you flying the season in Calcutta, on the east, and these things are, I mean, it's difficult to say, no, for anyone.
Mr. Sir, you have given a very good suggestion. If you have taken lockdown, then what will happen? The reality industry will start construction. Migrant labor will not go either. Titar bitar will not happen. Construction activity will start. तो फर्नीचर का डिमांड बढ़ेगा, सबका डिमांड बढ़ेगा. तो फिनाल 2 लाख टन के हम 4 लाख टन बेच सकते हैं 2 मंथ बाय अनदर पुटिंग अनदर प्लांट इन 18 मंथ्स. तो जरा वो जरा लॉकडाउन उठाइए प्लीज.
राइट सर, अनदर क्वेश्चन दैट वी वर डेफिनेटली लुकिंग फॉर द डाउनस्ट्रीम एसीटोन डाउनस्ट्रीम देयर यू मेंशनड दैट डेफिनेटली देयर मे बी सम डिलेज. आई मीन द डिलेज यू थिंक दैट इट विल बी लाइन ऑफ 1 or 2 quarters और
acetone downstream, so we have already started, no IPA.
Yeah, so IPA is one which is coming. So I'm thinking
Your next project.
Yeah.
Second, next project.
Retail. So next project, of course, I have been saying this, we have definite plans of going ahead with downstreams. There is no doubt on that. Now, if you ask me how far we have progressed on this, today is not the right time to discuss. We'll discuss at an appropriate time, maybe next quarter or quarter after that. But there are plans, so there is no issue on that.
Thank you. Next question is from the line of Pallavi Deshpande from Samisha Capital. Please go ahead.
Yes, sir. Thank you for taking my question. Just two questions here. One would be on the cumene, what would be the capacity utilization there, and in case of phenol, how much is sourced, how much is used in house sources, how much is sold outside?
You are talking about cumene or phenol?
No, first I wanted cumene capacity utilization.
So cumene goes for phenol only.
Right.
It will be 70-75% the way we run our phenol plant.
Right. Okay. And in terms of this Dajda, like you mentioned, that you know, what would be right now China's contribution currently to the global supply? Any figure?
This is, I mean, China's supply and is very difficult to say. But there is a demand compression in. So I mean, there are not many producers of Dajda. So.
Right.
And it's okay. Nothing. Neither they are doing great, nor anybody else is doing great.
Right. Right. So, what is the? I mean, in terms, I just wanted to understand total industry supply. How much is that, and how much would be share of China within the total global supply? It used to be 20%. This largest player who went bust.
They were not 20%.
No, she's saying we are 20%.
China, she's saying. You are talking about China or Deepak Nitrite?
Yeah, the largest player in China who had a fire, his capacity was 20% of total global supply, was my understanding. So, I just wanted to understand.
Dajda manufacturer did not have any fire.
I'll just answer this question. Okay. I am not aware of any such fire. However, it's safe to say that there is no new production there's no new producer of Dajda. And at the same time, the market share between the incumbent players, including Deepak, remains the same as it was in the preceding 12 months. There's no change to that.
Okay, right. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Next question is from the line of Tanvi Jain from Hem Securities Limited. Please go ahead.
Okay, good afternoon, sir. Congratulations for a very good set of numbers. My one question would be, as a joint rate, I just wanted a guidance on the overall capacity utilization, not for a particular segment. So just to know that what is the overall capacity which you are right now working, so including all your segments on a consolidated basis. And next would be the second question. Sir, as you started IPA acetone from the acetone division, and we are, say, expecting an additional revenue of, say, 250 to 300 crores. So this acetone is now used for in-house production. So will there be some, less of supply of the main acetone product as it is using in-house, or with an additional 250 crores. So just a bit guidance on that. Thank you.
The 250 crores, 300 crores, what we said is for IPA.
Okay.
And not acetone. So I think acetone, of course.
Acetone would be now used for in-house consumption for IPA as it is a downstream.
Yeah, but not full acetone. It's not that entire acetone is going for IPA.
Okay.
So, it is just a portion of acetone going to IPA.
Okay. Any guidance for which to what portion? If you could just give a small guidance, if that at all possible.
The ratio is 1:1.
Ma'am, we produce 1.2 lakh tons of acetone. Out of that, 30,000 tons of acetone will be required for IPA plant, the ratio being 1:1.
Oh, okay. Thank you, sir. And sir, just a general guidance of the overall capacity at which you are working, not for any particular segment in general.
I say 75%?
Overall, okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Next question is from the line of Ankit Kaur from Systematix Group. Please go ahead.
Thank you, sir. Thanks for taking my question. My question with regards to more of the end user industry on a Dajda OVA chain, sir. For us, the detergent is a larger end user, or a textile or any other, or paper probably. This invention for the perspective of essential in nature, be it which kind of it was.
Hi, thank you for your question. In the past, paper was the dominant market share out of the three. However, in the last couple of years, this has tilted decidedly into detergent's favor, and the COVID pandemic has actually biased it even further. So we can say that the significant majority is the detergent segment, which is actually growing much faster than it was 6 months ago. Paper has taken a backseat. Textiles was a minnow anyway, and continues to be that in India because a large part of it is from the MSME side.
Right. I'm just trying to understand more on why prices are fell. This is mainly because OBA plants being closed globally, or it is to do with the end user industry, let's say textile for the time being.
It is all end-user segment-driven, paper and textiles being more discretionary spend. And paper, being very large continuous operation, requires significant manpower.
Okay, thanks for that. Secondly, my question with regards to power costs and other expenses, which also have reduced quite a bit in this quarter, despite a better volume. What would be the basic reason behind that, and should we take this as a sustainable number, or any take on that?
The power cost, of course, it's a variable cost. So if 10 days plant is shut, then power cost will certainly be lower.
Right.
Otherwise, there are no major changes in the power cost as such.
Okay, that's the only reason. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. Next question is from the line of Rohit Singha from NK Global Financial Service. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thank you for taking my question, sir. First of all, congratulations for the good set of numbers. So, would it be possible to just share what would be the overall growth in terms of volume or as well as in terms of pricing in the overall revenue? I mean, how much growth was there from the volume and how much growth was there from the pricing?
You're talking about last year, right?
Yeah.
So, last year volume growth was also there, but price was a major this thing, and particularly Dalta, which you all know. So,
yeah.
It was a significant contributor. So, of course, there was a volume growth, but then last 10 down shutdowns that impacted that. But price has played a major role.
So any number you can quantify? How much would be the volume growth and I mean 10-12%?
There is no segment-wise. It doesn't, I mean, if I give you rough, say 5-7%, it doesn't make any sense, you know. Because we are
right.
In bulk, we are in finance specialty, we are in performance. So if then you have to understand each segment and each product rather than just giving you ad hoc number.
Correct.
So you will
correct.
Do a mislead, calculations will go haywire if you do like that.
Correct. So so any color on maybe on the phenolics and the overall standalone numbers? Phenolics volume and standalone volume numbers?
The first year I have 100 crores profit.
Right.
And we almost touched 2 lakh tons of production. So phenolics has done actually really, really well. First full year of operation with 100 crores profit in spite of this challenging situation. And I mean, top line also, you know, around 2000 crores. And so reasonably good.
Okay. And how much growth was there in the export market? Overall growth number?
You're talking about Deepak Nitrate now?
Yeah.
Export is around 44% of our total revenue. It has grown because Dalta is largely exported. Okay.
Okay.
This could be what you are saying is because of price increase also. But export has really done well and will continue to do well there.
Okay. Okay. And
sorry to interrupt you. I'll request to come back in the question queue for a follow-up question. Thank you. Next question is from the line of Roshan Naik. Quintus of the advisory, please go ahead.
Thanks for the opportunity for follow-up questions. So, did the exports see any impact due to lockdown? I mean, is it continuing now or the things are like normalized?
I want the things are normalized, but our business, touchwood, we are doing really good in this. Initially, we lost few days because of lockdown and shutdown, and there were some issues with banks also, the documentation, and but gradually things have settled down, and you will see. I mean, we will not disappoint you in the first quarter result also. Don't worry too much. Of course, it cannot be. You don't compare with last year's and this, for God's sake. वो तो होता नहीं है. So, but we will be reasonably, we'll be doing well in spite of all the challenging and difficult situation.
Okay. Yeah, all other questions are answered. Thank you.